Just a note that during the announcements, we'll be taking up our Sunday collection, so thank you for your ongoing generosity. So, Ash Wednesday falls on February 17th this year. That is just 1 month away, and we will be offering Masses at 8:30, noon, 6 p.m., and 7:30 in Spanish. Please sign up through Realm. And speaking of Realm, there is a lot more you can do with it than just signing up for Mass. We highly encourage you to upload a profile picture to help our team and our parish family connect faces with names. You can also customize your account privacy settings to control what contact information is able to be shared. Other features include being able to view your giving history, to register for events, and set up any parameters for new donations. So if you have any questions or you haven't joined Realm yet, please reach out to the parish office. So please spread the word, as we are still looking for a part-time cleaning person at 20 hours a week. Please send a resume to Jerry Volker. Thank you for your help. The USCCB has invited all Catholics to observe January 29th, marking the 48th anniversary of the U.S. Supreme Court's decision legalizing abortion. We will be offering a rosary at 6 p.m., a mass at 7 p.m., an adoration of the Blessed Sacrament from 8 to 9 p.m. Are you a freshman or a sophomore who would like to be confirmed? We'd love to hear from you. Please contact me, Miriam, at the parish office to find out more about joining a small group which helps prepare teens for confirmation. And any adults who have not yet received their first communion or confirmation are welcome to participate in Disciples Believe. It's a 10-session program that walks you through the foundations of the Catholic faith. Again, please contact me for details, and you can join at any time. I invite all of you to pray for and remember those who have recently passed in our parish community. Helen Meeson's funeral mass will be celebrated on Friday, January the 22nd at 11 a.m. Mike Wilcoxon's funeral mass will be held on Saturday, January 23rd at 11 a.m. Both funerals will be private, but all are welcome to attend via live stream on our Facebook. The presiding homilist for Mass today is Father John. So let us all take a moment to invite the Holy Spirit into our hearts as we prepare to celebrate this liturgy.
Please stand. Thank you.
with your spirit.
Really good to see all of you here as we celebrate the second Sunday in ordinary time. And this time is anything but ordinary. But it is an opportunity for all of us to truly open our hearts and grow in our relationship with our Lord. And so as we gather, then we look at our lives, we look into our hearts, and we ask forgiveness for all of our sins. I confess,
O my God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my own serious fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am, Lord." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." you called me. But Eli answered, I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep. At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, here I am. You called me. Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, go to sleep. And if you're called, reply. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. When Samuel went back to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, Samuel, Samuel. And Samuel answered, speak, for your servant is listening. Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord, because the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body. But the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
John was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what he said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come, and you will see." So they went and saw where Jesus was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 in the afternoon. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Come and see. I love the Lord Jesus with all my heart. with all my soul. I do not want to shove this love down your throats. I do not want to force you to simply follow rules or dictate to you what you are doing wrong. I want to share my love for the Lord Jesus with each and every one of you. A love that changes lives. A love that journeys with you on the correct path. It has changed my life. Come and see. I can tell you that if we choose to live a life separate from Jesus Christ, right now, if we choose that way of life, that is what he will give us for all eternity. A life separate from him. I do not want that. I want to live with Christ forever. Come and see. Two of John's disciples were following Jesus. Jesus noticed that they were following him and asked them, What are you looking for? And they weren't really quite sure. They just knew that John the Baptist said he's the one, go after him. And they replied, well, Rabbi, where are you staying? And Jesus said, come, and you will see. Now, Jesus was not taking them to a nice apartment with a large screen TV, 4 bedrooms, 5 bathrooms, and a kitchen to die for. Jesus invited those two men into a relationship with him. Jesus did not want just a superficial encounter. Come on to my house. But something real and life-changing. They spent the day together in the place where he was staying. Now in our gospel today, we really do not know what they really talked about. But we knew, though, that their lives were changed because of their encounter with Christ. They had answered his call to come and see, and their lives would never be the same again. In fact, one of John's disciples, a man named Andrew, was so excited about what he saw in Jesus that he ran off and found his brother. Simon, you've got to come and see this. This is exciting. Come and see. Share in this good news. My brothers and sisters, I like what I see. Come and you will see. If we look in Scripture, and if we really look around us, even today in our present time, we can see various reasons why people might want to follow Jesus. And one of those reasons might be because he is a miracle worker, the healer. People came to him from Jerusalem, from Judea, from the Emea, even further south, from the east, beyond the Jordan, from the northwest, and even the coastal towns of Tyre and Sidon. Why? For healing. For miracles. Today, many people run to Jesus because he'll fix my marriage. People come to Jesus because he'll help me out financially. People come to Jesus because he's going to give me a better life. I just know it. People come to Jesus because he's going to cure a disease. People see Jesus you know, as a personal benefit, as someone who will kind of answer to my call, to what I need. But you always have to remember that those people were also the same people who cried out, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Interesting. However, my brothers and sisters, there are many who come to Jesus because they hear the call. They hear the invitation, and they follow him. They come to Jesus because they want a lasting relationship. Andrew and the other disciple with him heard the call, and they went after him. And Andrew liked what he saw, and he could not help but share that joy. In our first reading today, we hear about young Samuel serving in the temple. And one night, as he slept, Samuel heard a voice calling him three times. And three times, as would have been his responsibility, to get up and to see how Eli is doing. An elder, a priest of the temple, a blind man at this time, Eli, who had truly prayed and was open to really listening to God for many years, he started to sense what was happening in the life of Samuel. And so he instructed Samuel to speak and to assure God that he was listening with open ears, attentive. And when Samuel did as he was directed by Eli, not only did the Lord speak, but the Lord stood in Eli's presence before him. Samuel received a revelation and had the courage to speak to the Lord and accept his prophetic ministry. You have to remember it was Samuel who would anoint Saul and David as the first kings of Israel, transforming the entire history of the people of Israel. We follow Jesus, my friends, because we hear God's call and profess our firm belief in him as our Lord, as our God. We humbly acknowledge that without him, we are nothing. We're nothing. And we can do nothing. He is the reason for our being. He is the reason for our existence. It is in him alone that we find fullness of life, that we find happiness, that we find salvation. When we discover the Lord, we are strengthened and we are encouraged to face whatever challenge, whatever trial may come our way. You know, as we look around us, we see many who are lost, filled with anxiety, not sure where to go. They go through life looking for meaning and happiness in the world of drugs and alcohol, materialism, various vices, selfishness. People need us. People need you and me. We have the duty to tell them about Jesus. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold. And like St. Andrew, we must bring Jesus to others. The world is in a deep crisis. But this is not a reason to fear and to do nothing. Instead, this is an opportunity for us to strengthen our faith in the abiding presence of Jesus Christ. And so, my friends, be like Samuel, who truly listens
who hears the call, and be like Andrew, who runs to others. Tell them what you see, what you experience. I remember a mother years ago who said to me, she said, "Father, I don't know what to do. You know, I have forced my children to go to church. I have forced them to go to religious education. I brought them to CCP every week. I have forced my child to follow all the rules and regulations. And yet, my child, now grown, no longer goes to church. My child, now grown, does not really live the Catholic lifestyle." My friends, what people need today is not a good preaching to, but a revelation, seeing in you love for the Lord, seeing in you the excitement and the enthusiasm of what is really important. You know, one of the things I just enjoy is jet boats. You know, have you ever been to the Willamette on the jet boat? I love it. It's exciting. And you go, it goes really fast under all those bridges, and the water is splashing, and people are laughing. It's exciting. I want you to come this summer. I'm hoping we can do it together. Let's take a trip and get on those jet boats. It'll be great. That's the kind of excitement we must share about our church, about our life in Christ. So, my friends, come and you will see.
And now let us profess our faith proudly and boldly. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection. Life of the world to come. Amen. And now we just take a moment and turn to our God with all of our petitions. For Pope Francis, that in teaching the Church about the mystery of Jesus, he will continue to do so with clarity, simplicity, understanding, and respect, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, as we install a new president and vice president this Wednesday, we pray that there will be integrity and wisdom in all of their decisions, and respect and peace among all who live in our great land. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, enduring a rapid increase in the coronavirus, that people will cooperate with health authorities, that the vaccine will be given with greater speed, that the sick will be healed and those who care for them be protected. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. prayer.
For a greater understanding among all people of the sacredness of the human body, that purity of heart and mind, compassion and respect in every touch, and charity and tenderness in every action will reshape every relationship, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all baptized Catholics, that like Samuel, we will be faithful to our call to follow Christ, especially those chosen for the unique consecration of priesthood or consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in recent natural disasters around the world, that their home may now be with Jesus in the Father's heavenly home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we praise you, we glorify your name. Guide us on our journey. And as the disciples follow the invitation to come and follow you, help us to do the same. And help us, like Andrew, to be excited about who we are and to share our love and our experience with the Lord, with everyone else. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, Holy Father, by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominion, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new law, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory
command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace to grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, that we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grace to grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Share with each other a sign of peace.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through our Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Well, I want to thank all of you for being here. Wasn't this great? Wasn't this exciting? Boy, I can't wait to go there. Thank you.